people say, people think I'm some kind of buzzkill. No, they don't want to take me to the movies anymore because I might ruin it for them. No. Okay, here's Mark Twain said, first get your facts straight, then distort them at your leisure. Okay? Mark Twain. That should be the credo of producing. Because if you don't even begin in a place that's real, and then you take creative latitude, and your creative latitude starts stepping away from an imaginary place rather than from a real place, and then nothing ends up correct. Nothing even ends up imaginatively correct. So let's move straight in. Let's look at astrophysics in the movies. Killer asteroids, right? Let's see what we got here. Okay. So wait. Look at that way. Wait. Okay. So I'm leading off with the 2010 Bud Light beer commercial, which premiered during the Super Bowl. Okay, here it is.
Well, guys, that asteroid is going to destroy the Earth.
There's only one thing left to do.
Remember the date on this was 1996, wasn't it? So they have one coming, hitting the south tower of the World Trade Center. Those are the twin towers there. But another thing, asteroids are not hitting you horizontal to the Earth's surface. It's not really going to happen. They're going to come from the sky, not from New Jersey. I'm just saying. All right. How big the asteroid actually is. So here we go. On the monitor is the president, who's been lifted into Air Force One, and he is communicating with engineers at NASA. Here it is.
What is this thing?
It's an asteroid, sir.
How big are we talking?
Sir, our best estimate is 97.6 billion.
It's the size of Texas, Mr. President.
Yes, sir.
Damn, we didn't see this thing coming.
Well, our object collision budget's $1 million. That allows us to track about 3% of the sky.
I beg your pardon, sir, it's a big-ass sky.
Billy Bob Thornton, it's a big-ass sky. There we go. So, here we have the 1990s, and an asteroid the size of Texas gets discovered. We would have discovered an asteroid the size of Texas in the year 1800. There are no Texas-sized asteroids lurking in the solar system, ready to rear their head and take us out. And then, by the sky is available to everyone. The only way these movies work is if the government finds out about it, and then they keep it a secret. Except the best telescopes in the world are not controlled by the government, right? And backyard telescopes can actually discover asteroids and comets and all exploding stars. You can't hide that from the world. You will go before the government will, right? Next time, just so you know, right? Aliens, let's check this out. So one of my favorite movies, Contact, from regular story, It explores, I think, with some awareness of what the public reaction might be to the discovery of extraterrestrial intelligence, of a higher intelligence than our own. And it's an exploration of the science, the culture, the politics, and especially what happens in our civilization. So, in this scene, we are at the Arecibo Observatory, the world's largest telescope. It's a radio telescope built into a crater. So it's a non-spherical telescope. And the way you look at different parts of the sky is they move the focal point suspended above the dish. So this is ideal for actually looking for alien signals. This is Jodie Foster on the right, of course, Matthew McConaughey on the left, and I'll quote him, he says, I'm a man of the cloth, because he's a theologian student. He's a man of the cloth, but without the cloth. So that allows him, see, if he's not of the cloth, that opens up all kind of possibilities here, right? All right, so she's the astrophysicist, and he's trying to write about scientists, and she is his subject. For his notes, for his book he's going to publish. But in this exchange, she estimates how many alien-like civilizations might be in the universe. Here we go. Oh, by the way, this is the last scene before they kiss. She starts talking astrophysics, right? And then every sentence they get a little closer. Just watch this, right? And listen to what she says. Here it is.
Now there are 400 billion stars out there, just in our galaxy alone. If only one out of a million of those had friends, all right? If just one out of a million of those had life, and if just one
a waste of space.
And so they didn't kiss. I stopped it just in time. How old are you? Yeah, I got an 8-year-old in the second row. Save him that embarrassment of watching two grown-ups kiss. I might have missed it by a millimeter right there. Why am I showing you this scene? Well, this is 1997. I attended the world premiere of this film in Los Angeles. It's not something I do. I'm very non-world premiere kind of person. But I was invited to that because I was friendly with Carl Sagan and his widow. And so I'm there and I watch this scene and I cringe. I cringe. Here's why. She just recited what is basically the Drake equation. The Drake equation was advanced by Frank Drake. He's up there in the right-hand corner. Of course, he's still alive. I think he's like 130 or something. He's like just still alive. And so here's how you do it. You want to estimate the number of civilizations that are out there in the universe, intelligent civilizations. And I've simplified it, but the way I've simplified it doesn't matter. The essence remains. So how would you do that? Well, you start with the total number of stars in the universe, and you start multiplying it by fractions according to your estimate of the likelihood of the value of that fraction. So if we start with a gazillion stars, what fraction of those stars have planets? Is it 1 in 10, 1 in 100, 1 in a million? So that's the first fraction. Then what fraction of those planets have life? So you start multiplying these, and the number gets littler and littler and littler. And what fraction of them? You can have life, but maybe it's not intelligent. So then you multiply by the fraction that might have intelligent life. And in the end, you're left with a number of total civilizations in the galaxy. Okay, so she basically recites this Drake equation, which is a nice tip of the hat to Frank Drake, without having to be mathematical about it. They turn it into a love scene. Okay, so here is the love scene numerically. Okay, we start out with 400 billion stars. This came out of her mouth. 400 billion stars. If only 1 in a million of them had planets, and only 1 in a million of them had life, and only 1 in a million of them had intelligent life, there would be literally millions of civilizations to search for. But if you multiply these numbers one times by another, you get that! Jodie Foster on this.